Corporate right now. Take a look. Wow. I just took off my shoes, but I was wearing these cute little like studded flats that had like gold detail. But okay, so check it. Yeah, girl just got back from a little something. Let me explain. As y'all know, I am in the process of transitioning into the tech industry. I've been taking my tech courses and stuff, and I actually passed my test last week. So I am officially a certified Scrum Master. If you don't know what a Scrum Master is, it's kind of sort of like a project manager for tech companies. So I did that, and I'm still enrolled in my project management course because I do plan on getting that certification later down the road as well, but I do want to get more experience. Okay, I'm not going to get into everything because I don't want to bore you guys for those of you who are not into tech or anything. So pretty much when I say I'm transitioning into tech, my goal is to transition more into like the business side of tech. So yeah, long story short, y'all, I've been grinding like crazy, and I'm gonna get more into detail once everything is set in stone, but I cannot wait to share my testimony with you guys, because if y'all only knew, it's wild.
Yeah, wow. All my bitches Spanish, Boricua. Water on my neck, these diamonds came with coral reef. Acting like a diva.
Hey guys, so welcome to another day in my life. As y'all saw in that little clip, my car, that's why I stopped vlogging the last clip y'all saw me. That's why I stopped the vlog, because my car was sounding like it was trying to shut off, and I just recently had like some stuff done to this car a couple weeks ago. So I'm like, child, car troubles are so stressful and annoying because I'm not by my dad. Like back home, like if something was wrong, my dad would, you know, always look out for me. But it's like being out here is just like a little scary. And plus my little guy friend is out of town that normally, you know, always come through if I need something. So it was just like I don't know, just annoying. So that's why I stopped the vlog, because I was like getting really stressed and anxious. So I waited until today, and I went over to where I get my oil change, had them check it, and they said that something was like loose, so they just tightened it for me and then topped up my oil, so I should be fine. But right now I look crazy. Right now I'm on my way to Zara, because I just want to look I haven't been to Zara in a long time. Just kind of want to peep in and see what's new. And then the reason I'm really going over there is because I have a lash appointment. And the lady is over there. So yeah, come with me to get my stuff. Hey guys, so I just made it to the mall. I'm at Baybrook Mall. This is my favorite Zara to go to. I have a lash appointment by here in like about an hour, so I decided to get here a little early so I could go stop at Zara.
Hey,
cute this bag is. Reminds me of Balenciaga. And this one is so nice. It's like a denim. I really like this. That is so cute. And they also have it in silver. And then I don't really like the black. But this one's cute. Pants. So I got them in black to see how I like them. The quality seems pretty good, so I'm excited to try that. And then I picked this shirt out just because I love like a nice white blouse. I feel like I could style it tons of different ways. So I got this to go with these black pants, but I'm not really sure how I feel about the black and white together. I'm not sure. I'm gonna try it on to see. And then their knits are so soft and cozy. Like, this is so soft. I love pink, so I got this cute little cropped turtleneck. And then I've been wanting like a nice pair of like black leather shorts, but this one is a skort, so we'll see how that looks together. And then I found these really cute over the knee black chunky boots, so I felt like that would look really cute with this outfit. So I'm gonna try these two on to see how it looks, and I will show you guys how everything looks together. Alright y'all, so this is the first outfit. I really like the idea of this one. Like, I love this sweater so much. And I like the way it looks with the black leather. But this skirt is just not for if you have like curves. Like, I'm like literally about to spill out of this. The boots are really cute. I really like them. I actually really like these. I'm just trying to see like what I could wear it with, because I don't have a lot of like cute skirts like this. So if I could find like a bigger size, like maybe a little longer, because like this is really short. This is cute. Alright, so this is the second outfit, and I actually really like this one. This is very cute. I think I need to size up on the pants though. This is a size small. I want to try like a size medium. But I really actually like the way it looks with the top. I really like this top actually a lot. And yeah, I feel like with the right accessories, this could be a really cute outfit. I don't know, I kind of like it. I like how like the top is more feminine and the bottoms are more masculine, so I feel like with a nice pair of heels and like a pop of color, this could actually be really cute. Hey y'all, so I left the mall. I did not get anything. I did not get any of those outfits. They were cute. I just wasn't really feeling the way they fit, and then I had to leave to make my appointment. But if anything, I may order. I really like those pants, and I feel like if I got them in a bigger size, they probably would have worked. So we'll see. Anyways, I did get, you know, I had to re-up on the Ebony Woods. I got one for me and I got one for my sister. I'm going to ship it to her. So that's the only Zara where they have it in stock. The Galleria location never has Ebony Woods in stock. So I love that Zara. It's so chill, so nice and neat, like. It's worth the drive. It's definitely worth the drive. So now I'm at my lash appointment. And y'all, so this whole lash saga, let me try to sit y'all here. Is that better lighting? Yes, I'm parked outside of apartments. So this is what happened. I started going back to the lash tech that did my lashes when I first moved out here in Houston. It's over here, like towards the Baybrook Mall. And the reason why I went to her was because the job that I used to work at was close to this location. And one of my coworkers told me that she got her lashes done at this location. So I went to her for a couple of times, but then I decided like I'm gonna find somebody closer to like in my deck of the woods, because driving all the way out here is crazy. So yeah, I really loved the way that she did my lashes, so I was like, okay. Anyways, I find somewhere closer to where I live, but y'all already know the whole story I explained to y'all before, that I just was not feeling them. So I was like, let me like try to find, I wanted to book with this other girl that I found on Instagram, but she is booked for months and months, but I really love her work. So I was like, you know what, let me hit this lady back up since I like the way she did my lashes, and I'll just drive all the way out here. So that's what I was doing. Like after work, it's not too far from like the job that I have now. So I'm like, after work, I'll schedule my appointments. But her availability is so scarce. Like she is only available during the morning and like early afternoon. And it's like, I have work. Like, and then she's never, like she doesn't really have anything on the weekends. So I'm like, I don't know how I'm about to do this. Like, so I wanted a fill-in like really bad, right? And she's like, oh, like I have a friend that does lashes too. She's really good. I'll send you her information. So she sent me her information, and she does lashes like out of her apartment, which is not a problem, but I know that's common, like, you know, people do stuff out of their apartment, people do like their lashes, hair and stuff out of their apartment. I've never gotten my lashes done out of anybody's apartment, so I'm just hoping that it goes well. I mean, I trust this lady, like her recommending me to her, but my appointment was at 5:30, and she was like, oh, I'll text you whenever I'm ready. And I'm like, I don't have time for this. Like, this is far out from my deck of the woods. You know what I mean? Like, but anyways, I'm just trying to be patient. I'm just ready to get my lashes done. Low-key, like, I wish I knew how to do them myself, or I wish I had a friend that did them, because this trying to find, like, a lash tech is, like, annoying. It's annoying. But anyways, I'm so excited to get them done, and if anything, I will talk to you guys once I get these lashes on my eyes. Hey guys, so it's later on in the day. I just got home, showered, I'm about to go chill with a friend, get some food and just chill out. It's a rainy, gloomy little day here in Houston, so not really feeling like going out and really doing anything, so I'm chilling. I'm just wearing this white top and these sweatpants. Shout out, do you guys remember when I first started my boutique 747 collection? I started with these sweatsuits. Or wait, no, this was from like probably, it was after I got started. It was the collection that I dropped when I first moved to Houston. It was like these cute little sweatpants sets, and I still rock them to this day. So shout out if you guys remember that. That was like a year or two ago. But anyways, I'm about to go ahead and head over there and chill for the night. I may bring my camera. Yeah, I'll bring my camera just because you never know where the night's gonna take us. So yeah, my room is a mess. My room is a mess. Okay, so I'm not gonna show you guys. But look at my lashes. She did an amazing job. She took forever. She took a long time. But it's worth it. I really like the way that the lashes look. So, yeah. I made it home. It's like 12:30. And I'm so happy to be home. I'm just so happy to be home. I'm just so grateful, guys. Like, I'm so grateful. When I explain to you guys what's been going on and like share my testimony, you guys will really be able to kind of see like what I mean by when I say like God's really looking out for me. Like God's really got my back. Like I would not be here today if it weren't for God. And I'm just very blessed. Like, I don't know, like on the way home, like I was just thinking like, I am so blessed. Like even opening the door and like walking into my apartment, I'm like, I'm so blessed to be here. And I don't want to ever take that for granted. And it's a lot of, you know, stuff going on in my life right now. But when I really, you know, take a moment and I just sit back and I like look at the little things, I'm like, wow, I'm really grateful. Very, very grateful. In bed, tonight was a nice little chill night. And yeah, if anything, I will talk to you guys. If anything, I'll talk to you guys tomorrow. Bye, good night. Hey guys, good morning. I just made my coffee and y'all look how good. This looks so good. To be honest, I have not been to Starbucks ever since I got my Ninja barista system. And I'm not just saying that because I partner with them. I'm saying that like 100%. I have not been to Starbucks ever since I got that. And I told my mom and she was like, you need to add up how much you've saved. Y'all, the lighting is horrible. Like, and honestly, I don't see myself, like, I'd rather make my own drinks, to be honest, like, because I know how I like it. So, shoot, this is, mm. 10 out of 10. Anyways, I woke up this morning and I went to the gym, got a good, solid workout in. And now I'm just chilling and I decided like for today, I want to disconnect. Like I want to completely disconnect actually for the whole weekend. I have some content that I did yesterday when I was at Zara. I decided I wanted to do kind of like a, should I buy it or should I leave it? You know, that type of video. So I want to edit it and get that ready because I'll post it sometime this coming week. But I don't know, this weekend, I'm just gonna be straight up with y'all. I haven't been to work since Tuesday. And I've just had a lot of stuff going on, like just in general. And I feel like I just needed to kind of reset. And so this weekend, I'm not in the mood. Like I don't wanna hang out with anyone. I know I went out yesterday, but even yesterday, like, I was just kind of like, I don't know, like, I'm in this mood where I just kind of feel like being a hermit, and I just have, like, a lot of stuff on my mind, and I just don't feel like going out. I literally do not feel like going out. Decompress, and I, like I said, I tried going out yesterday, and that's just not the answer. The answer is just, I don't know. Like, I just feel like I need some time to disconnect from everything. I'm okay. Like, I'm not sad or anything. I'm just, like, overwhelmed. So, yeah. You may not see a lot of me the rest of this vlog. This may be the end. So, with that being said, if this is the end, thank you guys so much for watching this week's vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed. And we're gonna be back to it. I'm gonna see you guys in the next weekly vlog. Thank you guys so much for your love and your support. Your messages honestly keep me going and I appreciate you guys so much. And yeah, I will talk to you guys in the next vlog. Bye.